Hey guys, it's Drac, and I have an exciting new piece of Nerf equipment to talk to you about. This one's not official, but sort of official. It's very up in the air and kind of dicey as to where it falls, but what I want to talk about is this. This is the new 15-round clip, and it looks very, very real. The only thing that's different between this and the Demolisher clip is that while you can see here that we have on official Nerf clips, we have all of the markings where it's like 10, 15, 10, 15. Here we have the same style where it says 12, and then up here it doesn't say 12, but it is the same dart forward marking. These do not have the rubber bumpers, but the Demolisher's clip, the 10 clip, does have these rubber bumper attachments, as does this clip. This parallels kind of the Rapid Strike clip in some ways, or the newer style clips, in that it is transparent on one side and solid on the other. And what makes this much cooler is whereas the Demolisher's clip is a fake banana clip and only comes down this far and only stores 10 darts, this stores the full 15, 16 sometimes, and it does that by actually taking advantage of the entire length. The machining on this is identical to regular Nerf clips. Everything is the same, everything operates smoothly. It's nicer in some ways because the spring that they've used is a little bit stronger, but the entire like system for chambering it into a breech is just as smooth and just as clean as any other clip, which I think is crazy that whoever this company is over here, and you can see it just says worker and has a wrench, they have either gotten the machine files from Hasbro or stole them somehow to make these clips so that the breech is just absolutely flawless. And I think that that's too cool that everything fits well and is very solid, and it looks pretty cool in all honesty. I'm not a tactical style nerfer. I don't need like Picatinny rails or anything crazy like that, but I do like this. I think that it's really sweet. It's ergonomic. It's just a lot of fun, and at the end of the day, it holds more darts, and that's what's really, really cool to me, is that it doesn't only look good, and it looks exactly like something that Hasbro would have made, but in addition to looking good, it works really well. This is a blaster that I haven't launched the video on yet. I call it the Vamperage for obvious reasons. I think that that's funny, but it shows this clip fully loaded with 16 darts, and it's a medley of sorts. It's a bunch of elite darts and then a few Koosh darts thrown in, but I wanted to fire through it, and one thing that I think is neat is you can see how it wraps around and how they'll kind of move up as we go through. So instead of shouldering the blaster like I normally would to fire, I'm actually going to hold it out in front of me and fire in a very goofy way so that we can watch the clip go. And so that was all 16 with no skips and just went right through. So it's a very smooth operation all the way through. And I think that it's too cool that these exist. They are very difficult to get your hands on, but that is the reason that when I had the opportunity to pick up two, I picked up two and not just one, because they were a little bit pricey, but I wanted to offer up one to my viewers. So I have decided to put one of mine on eBay for you guys to bid on. So the link to that auction will be in the description box below. So if you, like me, think that this is super duper tactical and very neat, then you can pick up one of your very own. But all in all, I think that it's a cool product, and I'd like to see whatever company this is, this worker company, I would love to see them make some more, some just ridiculously huge ones for like cosplay purposes. I've been meaning to make Ceres Victoria's blaster for a very long time, and a just awesomely huge magazine would be very, very cool for that. But link to the eBay auction will be in the description, and I wanted to just kind of make an awareness that there are real banana mags out there that go all the way through. And the first person to comment about the difference between magazines and clips in terms of like actual firearms and Nerf is crazy. That debate goes on all of my videos all the time, and at the end of the day it doesn't matter because Hasbro calls them clips, so I like calling them clips. I understand that they are actually magazines in the technical sense and how they operate, but I don't think that that matters because at the end of the day it's Nerf or nothing and they're just goofy toys. So as always guys, thanks for watching. If you thought this was sounds neat, let me know. If you can think of a number of darts that you think would be ideal for this sort of setup, feel free to comment about that, because I'm not sure where we get to a point of perfection here. I feel like 15 is probably a pretty good number, but if 20 would be better, then let me know.